Hey guys, in this quick video, I'm going to show you how to write longer Facebook posts. Now, why would you want to do that? You'd want to do it for two reasons. One, Facebook seems to like these longer posts that are value-driven. They have some sort of educational component, or you're going to learn something from reading them. And people seem to like them as well. If they're learning something from that post, they're more likely to share it, they're more likely to engage with it, they're more likely to start following you because you provide value and not just advertisements all the time. So how can you write these longer form, value-rich Facebook posts? They work for me every single time. So let me show you what I do in this process. The first thing I do is Google the topic. Now, lists are the easiest thing to create. So I like to say 7 tips to getting started, 3 things to do today. I find that people really like the lists because they start somewhere and they end somewhere. And when you have completed reading a list, bam, you feel like you've accomplished something. So I recommend that you start off creating a list. Now, Google the topic. This topic that I'm Googling is how to start your own website business, or why you should start your own website design business, because we have a website design class coming up. So if I can provide some value-rich content on why to start a website design business, at the end I can say, now if you're ready and we can show you how to do it and you want to take it to the next level, come to our class, all right? So Google the topic, and then step 2 is rewrite the content. Don't ever copy it. It's not about cutting and pasting. It's about rewriting it, putting it in your own words. Definitely reorganize the list if you like their list. So, you know, put it in your own words, make it your own. And then you can see at the end of this list, I also have a call to action. So register for our next class. And then you can add emojis to the post. I have found that the best way to add emojis to the post is WhatsApp web. So if you have WhatsApp on your phone, then you go to web.whatsapp.com and you can load WhatsApp, put the content in WhatsApp, and I use the search emoji feature in WhatsApp to find the best emojis. Now I'm addicted to WhatsApp. I use it every day, all day to communicate with my team and my clients. I'm a WhatsApp junkie and I wanna make you one too. I love WhatsApp as a communication tool, but here I'm using it to find the emojis. I find that when I do it in Facebook, it takes me 3 times longer because Facebook does not have a search emoji function when you're creating the post. Lord knows why. I wish they did. So for now, let's just use WhatsApp. When you click on the emoji next to when you're writing the content, you click on the emoji, you'll see that this search emoji feature comes up, and then you can search the emoji. So put in the number 7, and then you would replace the 7 right here in your copy with the 7, you know, the number 7 here. Let me just show you in a minute. And then I go to canva.com to create my image. A tip for using Canva when you're creating your image is find free stock photo images that you can use, or use a photo of yourself. Highly recommended is to use a photo of yourself, but you can use unsplash.com or pexels.com or pixabay.com to find a photo of your, a photo that would represent what you're trying to do, and then put the article title here. And then copy and paste it to Facebook and boost it. Now, this is kind of pushing it with too much text on the image, but I'm going to try it and see what happens. Usually I get pretty lucky when my post contains a lot of content. So when you read that, it says, when you read the post, it says 7 reasons why you should start your own web design business. Number 1, businesses pay a lot for website design. Number 2, web design is an in-demand skill. Every business needs a website. So, you know, I'm giving these little tips that hopefully it will get shared and people will find that the content has value. Then put your link in the first comment. So even though I do have links in the post, people do read the comment. So the first comment, I want to take up that real estate and put my link in that first comment. And then I'm going to boost it or run an ad in the back end of Facebook with it. That's it. Well done. You did it. High five. Hooray. Create some longer form Facebook posts. Make it have true value so that people will share it, and then let me know what happens. This is Alicia Lyttle with your Facebook post tip. All right, bye.